For those that have followed my channel over the course of the last year, you know that I've been doing a fair amount of work with Kobra VR, which is a company that produces what I think are the best VR gunstocks on the market today. Simon, aka Falandorn, the founder slash creator of Kobra VR, recently reached out to share with me this haptic feedback pistol he's been developing. It's currently in a very early, rough form, and is really just a proof of concept more than anything else at this point. But Falandorn has a really cool vision for this device, which he needs your help with. So we'll talk directly to him about that in just a minute. Before we do that though, I'd like to share a little footage of me using this pistol in Half-Life Alyx so you can see it in action and begin getting an idea of what this could bring to VR. It certainly doesn't kick as much as a real firearm would, but having the extra weight of the pistol and haptic feedback solenoid and everything added to your controller definitely gives you a more realistic sensation of holding an actual handgun. And the haptic feedback just adds an extra layer of immersion to the overall experience. While the feedback is much less pronounced than that of a real firearm, it is a huge step up from the very slight rumble that you get from the controllers alone. The thing I had the most fun with, though, was switching it over to fully automatic, pulling a trigger and feeling that rapid-fire feedback as you see the virtual bullets spraying out at the digital bad guys can really put a smile on your face. Falandorn's ultimate goal with this device is to get a much improved version of this into the hands of as many people as are interested in it. The thing is, he lacks the expertise to bring his full vision to life, and that's where you, the VR community, come in. So now let's have our little sit down with Falandorn and find out exactly what he has in mind.
Hello everyone, sorry my wife's waving at me behind the camera. Right, to start it off then, let's go. Marisok has been looking at a haptic device that I sent him for a pistol. It's like a blowback pistol. I've tried out haptic devices in the past and they seem too heavy, the ones that you can buy off the shelf. So what I wanted to do was make one that was light enough to actually be used in all games and hopefully like a modular system to put on our stocks. About 2013-2014, Palmer Lucky started off the new VR craze with a DK1, which I picked up on after the Kickstarter, and then the DK2, which was really good. It was like my dream all my life, really, to have a proper VR shooter. And I think we finally got there with the DK2. You could really see things moving on. I picked up a Vive, HTC Vive, and while I was in Sweden teaching, I was a maths teacher, I came up with an idea for a gunstock, and this is before the Vive actually released officially. I just saw there was going to be a need to actually hold the controllers, so I started a community project on Reddit very, very early on, which is like a DIY build project, and it looked something like this. Now, I've just pulled this out of the shed, and I think this is the oldest noob tube in existence. It looked like this. This is actually made out of wood and plumbing parts, and I actually thought a rat was going to come out of this. You can see it's just falling apart. Like, but this was originally to hold the HTC Vive controllers, and it did a job actually. It was adjustable, but obviously it wasn't great. Other people picked up on the idea and made better stocks and moved on. I carried on my teaching career, and I sort of made stocks on the side, which was fun, but I wasn't really making any money out of it. So I left that for a long time, and then I came back into VR properly with the Index, and then I picked up a Quest 2, and when I saw how good it was, I sold the Index because the Quest 2 was just brilliant. The tracking was perfect for what it was. I used to get issues with the Index for tracking. I started hanging around with a guy called Kobra on contractors. He was just a really cool guy. And he said, why don't you start making stocks again? Because the market really hasn't moved on that much. He used to like my original designs and he said, you should try and get back into it. So I got back into it and started making gun stocks again, and things have taken off from there. We set up the company Kobra VR, me and my wife, and yeah, we kind of made a few different designs. This was the CQB, the updated version. We had the upcoming Maglock, which is just about getting sorted soon. That's a nice little rifle. This is the DMR, which most people will be familiar with. This is a good seller. I really like it. It's just a nice, easy rifle to use. The pistol was like a side project, really. The one I've sent to Marisoc is the recoilable one. This was just kind of the little fun plug-in one. It doesn't really serve a purpose. I used to shoot in real life. That's the reason why I decided to make a gunstock, because it was useless. Basically, trying to aim with the controllers waving around. So that's what drove me to do it. And I always wanted that haptic recoil. Open source is the main thing here. I'm gonna make sure everything's released. So the biggest strength that we have, I think, is the community itself, because there's so much talent out there. People have been contacting me for quite a few months really, saying I've got that idea for Haptikz, and I just haven't had the time or resources really to put energy into it. So I thought, I've been holding this information in, but what's the point? It's not really going anywhere at the moment, so it's better if everyone just gets that information, and then if they want to run with it, they can. I'm not a trained electrical engineer, but I am a mechanical engineer from uni. I did product design as well. So I've got some knowledge when it comes to computer-aided design and and basic sort of manufacturing, but I'm not very good with electronics and coding, things like that. So this is where the community is just so, we've got such a diverse VR community. There's a lot of skill out there, a lot of knowledge. And so I'm pretty confident. There's a guy that's already making wireless, I think it's Bluetooth controlled or Wi-Fi controlled Haptikz. He's kind of set it up from, it's like a PC VR where you have to run a third party program and then it fires the Haptikz. That would be perfect for this. So if we can collaborate with this guy, get him involved. I did contact him, but he's quite busy. He's doing his own little project, but he's open sourced his information as well. So I'm sure we can bundle this all in. Ideally, what I wanted to do was have not just a recoiling pistol, because I've seen that works, which is great. I'd like to have a haptic device that you can plug into a gunstock, and it's going to have a physical overlay on the trigger. So for games that aren't PC VR, it all works straight away. You can use it with all games that don't support it, but also with the option of it being wireless with Wi-Fi or Bluetooth, you can then use it, plug it in for PC VR, and then it'll actually fire correctly for those games. There's a solenoid that I use, but I've seen the other guy that's used it online has used one of the Rumble motors. I think that's actually quite a good idea. So they're quite lightweight as well. So the idea was to have the module that's compatible with any gunstock, rather than just like a walled garden where you've just got one gunstock manufacturer making a haptic device for their device. I think to have a little module that plugs into anything would be preferable, because then it's accessible for everyone, isn't it? Want to make it really cheap. The ones that are available at the moment are very expensive, I think, for what they are. Fair play, they develop that to their own strengths, but I think if it's a community project, we can bring that price right down. The components are relatively cheap, so I think that's something we need to work out. So the idea is the module to be self-contained, hopefully battery powered. The one I've got that Marisoc was using was, it could be available for main supply or battery, a LiPo battery, like 11.9 volt. I think it's probably better if it is all housed in the battery for the rifles. For the pistol, I'm not so sure, because I don't like the extra weight on the pistol. I think it takes it away from the experience. So that might still be wired on like a battery pack that you can wear, a lightweight pack. The idea is to make the pistol available so people can print that and you know, to build their own. Also for the module itself, a very basic one that you can fit on any rifle, we'll make that module available as well, the STL files for that. There'll probably be eventually a pro version down the line where we'll try and house it all for our own stocks in a way that's kind of unique and maybe gives people a better experience if they can't be bothered to make this themselves, or they prefer our stocks to fit it to you. So that's further on down the line, that's what we'll be looking at. Problems we're having is that electronics and coding, we've got no real experience with that. And I know you guys out there have got a lot of experience. What I was hoping to do is integrate the physical overlay with the Wi-Fi or Bluetooth connectivity with the open source material that's already out there. So we'll have a unit that's fully integrated. For instance, a good example is at the moment, the 5-volt Arduino little circuit board that runs off a separate USB power point power pack rather than the 12 volt main source. You could probably integrate that so it runs off the same power source. That would be easier, for example. Probably easy for you guys, not easy for us. That's kind of where we want to go with it. What we're going to do is set up some kind of forum or place that we can discuss things. If there's enough interest in it, there might not be very much interest in it. I think there probably will be a fair bit. We'll need a place to coordinate and to talk. So if you look in the description, or it might be in one of these links, there'll be some way to contact us through Twitter or through the website, or even through Discord as well, just to set up these initial forums. I'll probably put out some tweets just to let you know what's happening, just little updates, depends on the interest that we get for this project. Right, thanks for watching, and thanks for Marisak for reaching out to us to help with this video. Thank you, bye-bye.